Hey everybody, it's Cameron Timmer. I'm going to show you how to use professional color grading tools to make your streams look better in OBS and stuff. Now, of course, nothing beats good lighting, especially if you have a good camera you know how to use. But if you want to take your image to the next level, or you just want to add some special flair to your webcam or your games or whatever you're using it for, then this tutorial will really help you out. And before we open OBS and check it out, we'll make sure that we have Shaderfilter installed. So if you go to this download page on GitHub and download the installer for your system, just make sure OBS is closed when you run the installation. And while that's installing, you can leave a follow on this thing, and then you didn't scare me this time. But yeah, there's that thing that just intrusively tells you a message of some sort. Just ignore it. But now that you have Shaderfilter installed, we're going to hop right into OBS, and the tool that we're going to look at is called the Density Saturation Hue Shader. So the way we're going to find it is we're going to go into our filters, and we're going to add a user-defined shader, and I'll just call this DenSatHue, just for simplicity's sake. And I have a hue spectrum here to make this example a little bit easier to explain density. This is based off the RGB chips DCTL that Thatcher Freeman made for DaVinci Resolve. You don't need to understand that part of it, just know that that's where this came from. But we're gonna go into this density saturation hue filter. We're going to select load shader from text file, then we'll hit browse, and then we will scroll down until we find the density sat hue shader. We're going to go ahead and open that, and it's going to give us a slew of controls here that's going to kind of look overwhelming, but when we break it down, it's actually just three controls that we can have individual color adjustments on. And the three primary adjustments that each color will have will be density, saturation, and hue shift. Now, density is the crucial one here that's a little bit different to understand. It's actually a film term used to essentially describe that when a color becomes more saturated, it becomes lower in luminance. So if we increase our density, that means we're reducing the luminance level of higher saturated values. So you'll see that less saturated values are still being affected, but not quite as much, but the higher saturated values are being affected a lot. And you can just see that across any of the color spectrum here that we can adjust. But I just wanted to pull up this hue spectrum here just to explain that part of it to make it a little bit easier to understand. The rest of it we're going to go ahead and just do inside of the webcam. So I'll just go ahead and I'm going to re-add it here. And I just have a LUT that takes this image from a log state into a Rec. 709 state just so that it looks the way that it should. Now, typically, if you do your adjustments before you apply the LUT, it can be a way to make things a little bit easier to control or have a little bit more refined adjustments or to work in a slightly different space. For the sake of simplicity to showing how these tools work, I'm going to go ahead and apply it after the LUT. But normally, I would recommend going ahead and just doing it before. Now, the way we're going to show some of these other tools, the saturation and hue shift. The saturation is using a subtractive model, and if you're unfamiliar with subtractive saturation, it's basically the idea that as you increase saturation, none of your red, green, and blue values will increase, similar to how whenever you're doing a print or a film and you have cyan, magenta, yellow, and you add cyan, magenta, yellow to increase saturation, you're basically removing light information to make things more saturated. That's essentially how subtractive saturation works. So if I increase saturation in the red values, you see that there's none of these values going up. They're all going down as I increase saturation. That also means that there's a slight side effect, though. If I reduce saturation, that means the values are going to go higher in luminance. We can see actually how this differs between normal saturation. If I just go ahead and add just a regular color correction and I add saturation here, you'll see that all three values are trying to basically separate from each other, and this is called additive saturation. And this is a good time to show that we actually have global adjustments on this too for global density and global saturation. It means it's adjusting it for all six color vectors. So if I increase global saturation, you'll see none of the values are going up. They're all going down. And this kind of gives a little bit more filmic saturation, similar to how density functions. So I'll go ahead and remove this color correction for now. And then, of course, our hue shift is just shifting our hue on any given color vector. So anything in this red area here, we can shift it left and right. Anything in the yellow area, we can also shift left and right. And then let's just say we go down to the blue area because we have some in blue and cyan. If we push our blue shift, we can see that we can do that without affecting anything else in the image. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the scopes, like the waveform and vector scope, I have a video up there. It's somewhere. Wait. Right up there. There it is. I found it. If you look up there, you'll see the video that I made explaining these color scopes and how you can utilize them. But if we go ahead and just start playing with our tools, so let's say I want to make my yellows a little bit more dense, but make my face a little bit brighter so I can increase the density for yellow, but then decrease density for red a bit. And then if I do a little bit of the before and after here, you can see how that kind of brightens up some areas and then densifies some others. Sometimes I make up words in tutorials and it's great. But let's go ahead and just add some saturation here, maybe in the blue area and then the cyan area as well. Just add a little bit more density in this background area. Maybe shift the blues and kind of compress these hues together. And then if we look at that back and forth here, you can see how much that does without really breaking the image. These are meant to be really gentle adjustments, but of course you can also like push it way too far. And you ideally wouldn't want to do that. But again, ultimately, the way that I would normally go about using this is if I put it before applying a LUT. And you'll see that in this instance, it doesn't make a huge difference, but it is subtle enough to make it a little bit less noisy. So if I increase this density, you see I have a lot more room to work with to make the image more ideal because I'm applying it in this space right here. But overall, this can be used for a wide variety of things. If you wanted to put it on your gameplay footage and you wanted to just, let's say, completely desaturate the reds for whatever reason, you could just do that. And then anything that's red would be completely gray. Don't know why you would do that, but it's an option. But this tool really gives you a lot more control over how you grade or even correct your footage in the first place. And it really gives you a lot more accuracy that you wouldn't have normally had otherwise. If you'd like to see more tools like this, I've made a couple other shaders as well that Exeldro has so gracefully put into his Shaderfilter plugin, like this one. There's the Tetra shader if you want to check that one out, short for tetrahedral interpolation. Not that you have to have any idea what that means. I still kind of don't, but I know what it does. It has somewhat similar functionality to this, but it's a lot more for camera matching and specific color correction. But if you'd like to see even more color tools for OBS, there's a video right here and there's another one. Apparently there's two of them, but there's a couple other videos on my channel I've done about this. Let me know what you think, and thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment, do the like, blah, blah, blah. I'm signing out. What do you call a heavy image? Dense.